Hello friends, so today in this video we are gonna find out the Laplace transform of sine 3t e raised to minus 3t into hyperbolic sine 4t. Now to get a Laplace transform of such term, we do not have any standard formula which we can apply directly over here. So to get the value of Laplace transform of sine 3t e raised to minus 3t hyperbolic sine 4t, we have to first simplify the terms and we have to bring it in the standard formula format so that we can apply the formulas of Laplace transform and get the value of Laplace transform. So let's write down the function. So here I'll say that sine 3t into e raised to minus 3t into hyperbolic sine 4t equal to, now guys, sine 3t term I'll keep it as it is, e raised to minus 3t as it is, and for this hyperbolic sine 4t we can apply the formula of hyperbolic function. We know that it is equal to e raised to 4t minus e raised to minus 4t upon 2. So after applying this formula we will get 1 by 2 constant which is outside. This sine 3t e raised to minus 3t will multiply the first term, that is e raised to 4t, and here we will get in the bracket e raised to 4t into e raised to minus 3t is e raised to t into sine 3t, middle sign minus. Next, e raised to minus 4t into e raised to minus 3t is e raised to minus 7t into sine of 3t. So now we got the simplification of this term as 1 by 2 e raised to t sine 3t minus e raised to minus 7t into sine 3t. Now to get the value of this or the Laplace transform of this left hand side, we'll take Laplace transform on right hand side as well. So here I'll say taking Laplace transform on both sides. So on the left hand side we'll get Laplace of sine 3t into e raised to minus 3t into hyperbolic sine 4t, that is our question, is equal to Laplace of this. So 1 by 2 is a constant, I'll take it outside, and in the bracket we'll get Laplace of e raised to t sine 3t minus e raised to minus 7t sine 3t. Now since there is a negative sign between two functions, we can separate the Laplace transform or we'll apply it separately. So you will get 1 by 2 in bracket Laplace of e raised to t sine 3t minus Laplace of e raised to minus 7t sine 3t. Now to get the value, we have to solve these two functions and to get the Laplace transform of these two functions. Now let's start with the first function. So in the first function, we have Laplace of e raised to t into sine 3t. Now guys, if you'll observe it carefully, then you'll find that this function is matching with one property, and that property is e raised to at into function of t. It means here sine 3t is my function of t. So what is that property? So that property is nothing but first shifting property. Now what is it? So here I'll show you that in first shifting property we say that if Laplace of function of t is function of s, then Laplace of e raised to at into function of t is equal to function of s minus a, or Laplace of e raised to minus at into function of t is equal to function of s plus a. Now as I said that here your e raised to t sine 3t term is similar to this, so that e raised to t is your e raised to at and sine 3t is f of t. Similarly in the second function, here e raised to minus 7t into sine 3t we have, so it is also matching with the same property. So sine 3t is our function of t, whereas this e raised to minus 7t is our e raised to minus 8t. So here I can say that here the function of t is sine 3t. So this function is same in both the terms. So here also we have sin 3t and sin 3t. Now what is Laplace of this function of t? So the Laplace of this function of t is by the formula of Laplace transform, we have Laplace of sin 3t. Now to get the value of this, I am going to apply this formula. So Laplace of sin at is given by a upon s square plus a square. Now here we have Laplace of sin 3t. So that will become 3 upon s square plus 3 square. And let's say this as function of s, that is phi of s. Now why I am calling it as phi of s? Because in the property of first shifting theorem, we are saying that Laplace of function of t is function of s. So here Laplace of function of t, I am calling it as function of s. Now from this function of s, we are gonna find out function of s minus a and function of s plus a. Now in the first term, here a is 1, so a is positive. So here by this result we will get phi of s minus 1, because a is 1. So I'll say that it is equal to 1 by 2 in bracket function of s minus 1, middle sign negative. Now let's observe the second term. Here the value of a is negative 7, that is negative a. So in that case, whenever a is negative, we get positive a in function. So that will become function of s plus 7, since here we have minus 7. So here I'll write it down that it is equal to function of s plus 7. So now I've applied here the first shifting property. So here I'll say by first shifting property. Now let's evaluate the values, that is function of s minus a and function of s plus 7. So for that I am gonna use the function of s. So how to get function of s minus 1 from function of s? So here the function of s minus 1 we can get by substituting or by replacing s with s minus 1. So here we'll get function of s minus 1. Here we'll get 3 upon s minus 1 square plus 3 square. So here I'll say it is equal to 1 by 2 in bracket 3 upon s minus 1 square plus 3 square, that is 9, minus how to get function of s plus 7. So for that I'll replace this s with s plus 7 in phi of s. So we'll get 3 upon s plus 7 the whole square plus 9. Now from these two terms I can take 3 outside, so we'll get 3 by 2 outside. In bracket we'll get 1 upon, this will become s square minus 2s plus 1 plus 9, minus 1 upon, because 3 is outside, s square plus 14s plus 49 plus 9. So that is 3 by 2 into 1 upon s square minus 2s plus 10, and this is minus 1 upon s square plus 14s plus 49 plus 9, that is 58. Now let's do the cross multiplication. So we will get 3 by 2 into s square plus 14s plus 58 minus 1 into this. So the sign will change, since we have a negative sign outside. So this will become s square, and because of minus sign that will become negative s square. Then 1 into minus 2s is minus 2s, and because of minus sign will get plus 2s, and plus 10 will become minus 10 upon s square minus 2s plus 10 into s square minus 14s plus 58. Now by solving these terms, s square and minus s square will be cancelled. Here we'll get 14s plus 2s, that is 16s, 58 minus 10, that is plus 48, upon these two brackets as it is, that is s square minus 2s plus 10 and s square minus 14s plus 58. Now I can take 16 common, so when 16 will come outside, 2 and 16 will cancel, so 2 ones are 2 and 2 eights are 16, so we'll get 8 into 3, that is 24 outside in bracket s plus 3 upon these two brackets as it is, s square minus 2s plus 10 and s square minus 14s plus 58 as our final answer. Thank you.